scratch all over. In fact, as a baby, my mother put a poor baby cardboard on my arm so I couldn't bend it and scratch my face. She was afraid that I would leave scars on my face. Anyway, by the time I was 2 years old, I had asthma. I know I have 3 older brothers. They were all robust in health, with good health, my mother and father too. But for some reason, some genetically or something, I didn't have what they had. And so I was always asthmatic. Asthmatic meaning you can't breathe good and all that, yeah? And I used to miss about 1/3 of my school days. So in my grammar school days, I missed 1/3. So they put me in the slow learners class because of that, because I was absent so often. And when they had physical education and all that, I would have to go to a special room where I would lay down on a cot for about that period. And then when that period that physical education is over, I would go back to my class again. Well, the war came along, World War II, and I was born and raised in California. So all those on the West Coast were evacuated to, Japanese Americans were evacuated to various camps. I was in Northern California, a place called Tule Lake. Now, don't let the name make you think differently, but it was a dried up lake. There was nothing growing on that place. But in a way, it was good for my health because my asthmatic condition lessened. But I was still skinny and weak and fragile. But my next door neighbor, who lived in Barbados, so that was a good place. And he introduced me to weight training. So I got into weight training. And one thing led to another, then when the war was over, I was in the camp for 3.5 years. I went back to California, Sacramento, and attended high school. And it was in my senior year in high school that I was going to accompany a friend of mine to a weightlifting contest. And the guy said, well, if you're going, why don't you come? So I said, yeah, why not? I'm going, you know? So I trained a little bit for 2 weeks and got some kind of idea of how to live and all that. And I competed. And I took second place. But there were only 2 of us anyway. Anyway, I took second place in my class. But that wasn't my appetite. I thought, this is my sport. I like this. I can train on my own. I can train with a group. I can train anything, as long as I have a barbell. So I started training regularly. But believe it or not, within 26 months, I had made the highest record in the world. Because the World Championship was held in 1950 in Milan, Italy. And the total that won my class was 777. I had done 780 on the
list. Is that pounds?
And
pounds.
I mean, but that's a few lifts, though, you know. But I thought, gee, what I could do. Anyway, so I thought, next year I will compete in the national and win first place. I'll go on to the Olympics. That. And, but the Army, the U.S. was having a new war with North Korea. So I got drafted. And so for my ideal training and all that, after regular training, I thought, I think I'll take up cooking. Because if you're a cook, you work one day, you're off one day. You cook one day, you're off one day. And on the off day, I could train. So that's what I started doing. But you know, the North Koreans were very smart. They heard That's my story now. You got others.